Okay, hello there, ladies and gentlemen. It's time for chapter 6 of my Evil Within AKUMU walkthrough, where it's gone pretty damn well so far, and I think I've shown some strats on how to avoid getting too stressed if it is your first AKUMU playthrough, because as I'm making this, that is what I have in mind, trying to help people who are doing it for the first time, because everyone's different, and when I did AKUMU for the first time, even though it was ridiculously difficult and annoying, I would never have wanted to look online on how to make it easier. I want to do it myself. But everyone is different, and that in 2015 is a huge thing. People like to find out how to do things in an easier way. I'm not calling them out for that, it's just the way it is. Because I do know a lot of things about this game. Well, there we go. Look at these photographs here. And then we'll be upgrading
photographs
and keys. And chapter 6 is, without shadow of a doubt, one of the most infamous on AKUMU. I could easily die. I hope it goes pretty well, because
a church.
I know the strategies to make it a lot easier. Especially at the start of the church, but it can go wrong. It's a story of this game, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see. But the two vital upgrades that we will be needing here, without a shadow of a doubt, the flashbolt level 4 and the sprint level 4.
What was that sound?
So we've got 3 keys. Let's see what we can do. Harpoons, not the best thing in the world, but okay. Not awful either. The game, oh, that's good. At this moment in time, that's really good. That has come at a lovely moment. 3 flash bolts. I'll tell you why in a minute. But the game isn't giving me much green goo, and that is a concern. I'll get some here, I'm pretty sure of it. There we go. So that's 35 grand green goo. So there we go. Sprint level 4. Flash bolt level 4. There's a part in chapter 6 where I use the shot bolts a few times, so I'm going to get that to level 2. Look how cheap the matches are, man. Level 4 of the matches now can hold 15. Can now hold max bolts. 8 stock of the shotgun. And I'm also going to improve the damage of the handgun. And yet again, fire rate up to level 3, and the range of the crossbow, and I think those are some really, really good upgrades. And on your first AKUMU playthrough, the upgrades here at the start of chapter 6, absolutely vital. So we've got the shot bolt to level 2, we've already got the flash to 4, 50 matches, it can hold the maximum of bolts, 8 stock for the shotgun. The handgun's a little bit more powerful, and it's fast, which is very important when you shoot them in the legs, which is obviously the way to kill them on this game, really. Already got 5 bullets in the shotgun. Crossbow's coming along nicely. And, of course, maximum sprint is now a level 4. And usually, at the start of chapter 9, is when I like to upgrade my sprint to level 5. So let us just go back here and see wherever I can pick anything else up. I think I can take another explosive bolt now. Because you see there it says full, but you're actually not. If you actually get your explosive bolt out there, you'll see that you can actually carry one more. And I think the same can be said for the harpoon. But if I avoid dying more than two or three times here on Chapter 6, I'll be happy. I'm pretty damn certain I will die. It's one of the trickiest chapters. But hopefully, like I say, the strats will help you out. I'm kind of annoyed that the game hasn't given me any freeze bolts yet, because the freeze bolts, in my opinion, are the second to worst bolts in the game. Poison bolts. But on AKUMU, because you can shoot the bombs with the freeze bolt and then get the trap parts, they're actually very useful because of that. But the game hasn't given me a freeze bolt yet.
Leslie.
And when I say that, I mean from the lockers, because the first one that comes in the actual game itself is coming up very shortly.
Sebastian?
In the church.
Sebastian? Sebastian?
But the main upgrade that is going to help you guys survive, if it's your first ever AKUMU playthrough, or whether, you know, you're still really struggling, is without a shadow of a doubt the level 4 flashbolt. It is the lifesaver, and it is the thing that is the game changer, quite frankly, because this next part with Joseph is on a timer whilst he's unlocking the door. There are quite a number of things that can go wrong here, including the haunted attacking Joseph, which will stop him from opening the door as quickly as possible, which you obviously do not want, but also, if you don't kill the enemies in the correct order, in the correct way I should say, then an infinite number of them can spawn, especially in the second part of this fight coming up, because you start in the second floor, then you go downwards, there's no checkpoint, and when you don't know the game that well, it is very tricky indeed, very annoying. So I've got a grenade. I thought we were full on grenades, but obviously not. Oh yeah, you used one before, didn't I? So we're all ready to go, but believe you me, I could easily die straight away here. I might shoot the explosive barrel, I might use the shotgun. But even though I might die, the most important thing you're going to see here is the flashbolt strat. And I'll tell you as well when we go down to the first floor, how to stop the enemies from infinitely respawning, because that is the key thing here.
Shit.
And I don't even know what just killed me. Maybe I was just killed by a tiny fly that wasn't seen on screen, but that is AKUMU for you. I just got killed by nothing. That is AKUMU for you. I think she was meant to get up, but she actually didn't. But what you're waiting for now is for Sebastian to tell Joseph to hurry up. He was going to run for Joseph then. I'm just going to crowd control these motherfuckers. And when these arrive, I'm going to drop that. Now, there is a way of stopping tons of them spawning. There's five of them, and I would like a few of them to die here. So I'm going to throw a grenade. But I'm more clued up about the second part of this than the first part. As you can see, unfortunately, when you do use the flash bolt, the enemies tend not to take damage sometimes like that. It is really annoying and I cannot stick up for the game. Why that happens, I'll never know. It's not acceptable whatsoever. It's fucking stupid. And because of that, I'm having to spunk another flash bolt. I'm going to kill the fat fucker as well.
Got it. Let's go.
Priest came at me, knocked him back because he wasn't under the effects of the flash bolt. Now this is it here, where you can really stop him from annoying you and infinitely spawning. Let's get the shotgun shells. I bet four of them are going to drop down here. Oh, he nearly got me. This is it coming up now. Two fatties are going to come down. No, sorry. One fatty, one female, two normal haunted. Here we go. This is the game changer. Oh, one guy doesn't get flash bolted. That's cool. What you want to do is kill the female and kill the fatty. There is no logic to this whatsoever. But basically, if you kill them in that way, then no other haunted will spawn. But if you kill any others, if you kill one of these two, I'm not joking when I say this, about 15 of them will come down. And you will continuously die. Now, this part here, sometimes I have to use, and I might have to here, another flash bolt because my stamina is going low and these guys just do not stop running. It's a constant cycle of looking at my stamina, keeping my concentration, watching where they're running. But I might have to use it. I'm gonna use it because my stamina's running too low and he didn't get fucking flashed. Neither of them got flashed. Oh dear, you know I love this game, but sometimes, guys, unfortunately, the mechanics of the game just do not work. And we've seen it a few times in the last 10-15 minutes. The game's mechanics have just decided not to work. And I think I've wasted about 3 or 4 fucking flash bolts because of that. And that is so annoying. And unforgivable, quite frankly. But anyway, we're out of the one death. And I remember in my first AKUMU playthrough, it took me 4 hours. If I'd have looked online and saw someone doing what I'm doing, it wouldn't have taken me 4 hours because I'd have known what to do. It's still hard to replicate that kind of strat when you're doing it for the first time, but hopefully it will help some of you guys out. But yeah, what the hell is the game doing there? Oh, can't speak, I'm getting angry. Unfortunately, the flashbolt didn't work a few times, though. But anyway, I've just thrown that. Now I'm going to shoot them two together. Unfortunately, a lot of the strats that I use here are not working at the moment. And I should have been killed there. No, you come down. You come down here. Holy shit, he's dead. This part of the game is such good fun. But I am probably going to lose my cool on it. If you don't want to use matches, you can shoot them in the head like that, but it doesn't always work straight away. Sometimes it can be like 3 or 4 shots to the head before they die, you see. Crazy stuff. But I'm going to do this. And get the trap parts. Sniper rifle now in the game as well. Very good weapon. Even though it's an old school sniper rifle. But basically right here, ladies and gentlemen, as we can see, we've got these... Jesus Christ, they could easily hit you. I don't know what to call them, but... Oh, God. Basically, they are going to open at certain points. I think there's 4 altogether. Now, I could easily die here. This is very tricky, and I'm going to be doing it very fast. It's hard to do this part. In fact, it's impossible, I'd say, to do this part and fully articulate what the hell is going on. All I can say is try to follow what I do. But of course, I could easily die from the smallest kind of bullshit. That's AKUMU for you. But what I can assure you is that this is the easiest way to do this. There are other ways as well. But for me, this is the best way to do this part. What I'm going to need is yet another flash bolt. And I'm pissed off because I've used tons. Because the game has forced me to use them. We're also going to need an axe. Oh my lord, he asked me a question. We need that guy's axe before we do all this area. Obviously as well, Joseph can easily die here. And I'm just going to take that guy out of the equation because believe you me, he's a pain in the ass because he's got a fucking explosive bolt. But like I say, I'm just going to try and do this and not explain or articulate what the hell's going on. But for me, this is the easiest way to do it. Joseph has somehow taken damage. Oh, I don't believe it. Unfortunately, the game has screwed me over. That one at the bottom should fall, but it hasn't. No, it should. Joseph has taken huge damage. This is... Oh, God, there's only one left. Oh, God, this is crazy. I think Joseph's going to die here. This is not the way I anticipated this going down, but... There you go. Kill that guy. Oh, I am fucking out. I am full out of ammo.
Do you have any first aid?
Oh, the explosive bolt saved... Sorry, the poison bolt saved my ass there. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, this is brilliant gameplay right here. I'm not bigging myself up. I'm saying it's great from the game. It's so good fun. Such good fun, man. Can't express that enough. So that's the last one done. He is now gone. But I could still do with an axe. And this guy's got one. So I'm going to axe him a question, I think.
Nothing should stand in the way of getting to the tower now.
And I'll show you why you really need this guy's axe here. Right, I see that guy there. I see a few more of them. Ooh, oh, that's fucking bollocks. That is bollocks. Shame that that's happened there. All that progress, no lost, because that guy just grabbed us when he shouldn't have. We would have been onto the sadist fight. Obviously, you guys have played AKUMU, or you wanted to do AKUMU properly for the first time. You'll know that the sadist is coming up, because you'll have done it on a survival, but... Nearly did it all in one, but not quite. And for some reason, that guy... Oh, the game is kind of showing itself up here. I hate to say it, but... The mechanics are just not working at the moment. That's what should have happened last time, but it didn't. He's gone out the picture now. This part is very intense, ladies and gentlemen. I can't stress that enough. Fuck off. Good stuff. Right. That's probably gone better than it did last time, to be honest. No, I've got the axe. The axe is very important here to kill the sadist. And Joseph cannot die once you get here. And this is the fastest way to kill the sadist. If you've got a flash bolt out, would be good. Bolt in. Hit him with the axe. Hit him with the explosive bolt. He should die. If he doesn't, we'll just hit him with another. And he is dead. For some reason, when enemies are under the effects of the flash bolt, they can potentially take more damage. I don't know why that is, but this game is utterly insane, so there we go. But yes, a very fun, action-packed part of the game, but ultimately quite stressful as well. Especially when you're doing the insanity that is AKUMU for the first time. You will be raging here, make no mistake about it. And like I said, it's very hard to articulate what to do. Because there's so many enemies in so many different positions, coming at you at different speeds with different weapons. The gameplay is very fun. But like I said, it's a little too all over the place for me to articulate how best to do that. But in terms of the compartments, what the enemies are in front of me here, that is definitely the best way to do that part, no doubt. But yeah, I died once, but I'm happy to do it on my second attempt. Because all this part, it took me like 4 hours on my first AKUMU playthrough. Still quite a long way to go with Chapter 6. This is most certainly going to be one of the longest videos in the walkthrough. And now, ladies and gentlemen, something you can do, you don't have to, but I will be doing, is shooting an explosive bolt at Joseph. And if you shoot him there, at the chest, then this should work. At the end of the day, you are using an explosive bolt to perform this trick, so if you want to keep the bolts, you don't need to do it. You can just do this next part with the sniper rifle, as you should. But I like to save the sniper rifle bullets, so...
Do you think Kidman is okay?
That's what I do.
I don't like that they used her as bait. Almost like someone's toying with us. Hang in there. Just a little further.
And here you guys will see what I mean. So those two haunted take Joseph to the guillotine there.
You okay?
If you don't shoot them in time, Joseph dies, it's a game over. As long as you upgrade the explosive bolt to level 2 and you shoot him on the chest with it, like I just did before, then you'll be fine. Or of course you can just use the sniper. You can even get them with a handgun, but you know what the handgun's like on this game. It doesn't always work. Now this next part here, there are going to be haunted coming up this plank. You can manage to avoid taking damage from the Haunted. If you stand at the top of the plank, you can make it so they just run into you and they do not attack you. It doesn't always work though. I'm going to try it the first time, but I could just stand there and be hit, and obviously then I'm dead. So we're going to try it for the first time. If it works, then you guys will see it, and it can help. But if it doesn't work, the second time we'll just do it the legitimate way. Because this is on a timer, because Joseph is opening the gate for us here.
Let's go.
So I nearly died there. But basically, here it is. It might work, it might not. It's already working now, as you can see, but the other Haunted behind could hit me. If that happens, it happens, whatever. No, it's worked, as you guys can see, for now at least. Risky, but at the end of the day, you've got enemies throwing axes and dynamite at you. This can save your ammo. Obviously, we can't get that green goo, but this is really good. I don't think the developers of the game will be very proud of this moment, but there we go. And there we have it.
Hurry, this way.
Crazy.
Joseph, are you all right? Yeah.
So this right here, ladies and gentlemen, is yet another huge loot area. There are a lot of goodies to get. But it's completely random on this game. It really is. At times,
this looks like some kind of a market.
In the past, I've gotten a lot of things here. Right now, I don't seem to be getting much at all. Quite a lot of green goo. But I'll try and open this chest. I could die. But it's well worth taking the risk because I mean, the health kit there, I'm not going to be taking anyway, obviously, there's no point, but there are two trap parts. All important on AKUMU, of course. Go through here. Another key.
They were promised salvation and eternal life. But there's nothing that they promised that I couldn't take away.
Down here, 1 grand of green goop. Like I said, guys, huge loot area. I wasn't lying. So, the two other things that are coming in this chapter are Nuin and Zen, and the Franca Z boss, the Ralpha Z boss. You'll only know that phrase if you're on twitch.tv. Basically, the big dog boss, which on my first ever AKUMU playthrough took me a good hour or so and about 50 deaths, I'd say.
Where do you suppose we are?
Could easily die. I did die recently on my last AKUMU playthrough, but I'll show you the strats that you have to do, basically.
This place can't be
because on AKUMU, to do that without the crossbow is nearly impossible. Holy shit.
counting on you.
So I've got a bit of green goo at the moment and a few keys, so it's a good time to go back to the nurse right now. Ooh. And here, you sometimes get sniper bullets, sometimes you don't. It's one of those times in the game where it's completely random. Usually with ammo, you get it in the same place, but not there. Very happy to see that.
Hold on a minute. Let me climb up here and see if I can get a look ahead.
So there's going to be an asshole with a sniper rifle here. You can trust Joseph if you want. But guess what? I most certainly do not, so I'm going to be killing him ASAP. And then I'm going to be burning these bodies here because they're going to rise up in a second or two. And there is an explosive bolt that I could well do with having. There it is. And I'm going to... Now, it is time for Nguyen and Zen, and to be honest, they're not that difficult, they're good fun to kill, I like them, but recently on AKUMU they started to kill me quite a bit. The strats that I'm going to be using here basically bunch them together, because it is easier if you... give them damage with the same shot, for example, using the explosive bolt like that and hurting them at the same time. Or as if you damage them separately, I just think it's harder. But recently they started to kill me, so I hope they don't. But there's a little area of the game here. And I don't think it's a coincidence that it's the basically. I think this is what you're supposed to do. Because there's one of them. But the other one is only seen once you come out of here. And if you've got grenades, this part is a lot easier. But what tends to happen here is that they escape my shot bolt. But thankfully they haven't. That's good. Because now I'm going to give them the grenade. Now I'm going to give myself some space. Drop a explosive bolt. He's down. You know what? I don't mind dropping another. Oh, he's got a melee. That can kill you, obviously, needless to say, straight away. But he's on his ass. Let's finish him off. Nice. That went pretty well.
I'll look for another route. Let's meet up by the horse statue there.
But it's all about the early damage from the grenades, though. I used the shot bolt against the wall. The problem there is that if you're not quick, sometimes the one on the left will escape. And then, to be honest, it can become complete chaos. But of course, that fella breaks out from there, so if you run back to here, you're at least giving yourself a lot of time and space, and that's vital in this fight. That's Nguyen and Zen done, but the thing is, they're a lot easier than the Francozy fight. Because the dog, oh my lord. Its AI is just very random. All over the place. It will hide in the bushes and then jump out and attack you. And there are bear traps around as well, needless to say. Stepping on the bear traps kills you. So, you're automatically brought back to the hospital here, so I may as well use my keys. Shot is. Good stuff. Green goat. Green goat. Well, I've got quite a lot, so I may as well upgrade. I wasn't really anticipating or expecting upgrading until the start of Chapter 9, to be honest with you. But why not? But what you're going to need for the upcoming dogfight are the shot bolts and the explosive bolts. That combination. Now, I'm not sure, because like I told you guys before, the more you upgrade the explosive bolt, it actually gets worse. Because I don't hit the dog with the actual explosive bolt. I put the explosive bolt next to the dog. So I'm not sure whether level 2 or level 3 is better. I couldn't say for sure. I really don't know, guys. What I do know is that I'm upgrading the shotgun ammunition. And I'm upgrading the fire rate and the damage of the sniper and even the clip as well. And even the reload, because obviously, what with it being a sniper rifle, it's very slow. So that is something I'm going to do. By its very definition, the shotgun is slow, so improving the fire rate is good on that. And the most important thing with a crossbow for me is the reload time, so I'm going to improve that as well. So despite all those upgrades, I have 10,000 left, which is really nice. But there are no guarantees the dog won't kill me here. He well could. Because last time he actually went into the bush to the left of where he usually does. And that completely threw me off. Let's hope he doesn't this time. 9 times out of 10,
you don't need to worry about
he
me.
Will go straight forward. But he deviated to the left for some reason. And took me by surprise and it killed me. I'm pretty sure YouTube have a 2 GB file size limit. And that, for me on my laptop, is basically an hour of footage. An hour of footage is about 2 GB. And I'm coming close to 40 minutes now, so I don't think any chapter in the game is quite going to be that long, but chapters 6 and 10 are going to run it close.
What do you make of this writing?
Doesn't mean anything to me, should it?
Now hold on a second, I jotted something down earlier.
And as we can see, there is a key here.
It seems the sacrifices need to be lowered onto the proper altars, and the safe way to him will be open.
But it's good, you know, recently I've seen that on Twitch and just on the internet in general, there seems to be a growing popularity with this game, which is quite bizarre considering it's just about over a year since it was first released now, but Yeah, there are people who I think are playing the game for the first time and enjoying it, despite the somewhat lukewarm reviews it got. I think it got mixed reviews, really. Some really good ones and some like 6 out of 10s and 70% out of 100s, if you will. This game has problems, there's no doubt about that. But what it is when all is said and done, not so much on AKUMU, because AKUMU is very frustrating, and in my opinion, isn't that fun. But Nightmare is great fun. But yeah, one of the things this game is fun. It's really challenging. The gameplay is varied as you go through the game. The environments are varied. It could have done with a few new enemies. A few different enemies, I should say. The story is pretty cool, in my opinion. I like the story. But yeah, it seems like, funnily enough, it's getting more popular as it ages, and a lot of people want a sequel, as do I. The thing is, these days, in 2015, people are so easily swayed by your popular streamers and your popular video makers. So, when Markiplier, a guy I used to have a lot of respect, well, not a lot, but I have respect for, someone who I don't know, played this, he said, you know, The Evil Within's not that bad of a game. And then he played the DLC, and he said, oh my god, I'm not getting any weapons, this is awesome. And honestly, the DLC to this game, it's good for the story. It's pretty good. It's okay overall. But in terms of gameplay, not much happens. There isn't that much gameplay. But just because you didn't have a weapon, Markiplier loved it. And, you know, Markiplier's got a lot of teenage drones who watch his videos. And if he says this game isn't great, which is... He didn't say that, but basically... You could tell that was the case. And he played Alien Isolation at the same time, a game which I cannot stand, by the way. And basically, it was Alien Isolation's good, this is bad. And I completely disagree. But all these little preteen drones who watch him,
can you get it open?
Will have taken that on board, you see. That's the way it works in 2015, ladies and gentlemen. But Markiplier, on his first playthrough of this game, made a lot of mistakes, and he didn't get the crossbow until Chapter 6. You're supposed to get it on Chapter 3. Now, I'm not calling him out, because I made tons of mistakes as well, obviously. Similar to that on my first playthrough, but it's a game that makes more sense the more you play it in terms of its mechanics and the guns, the bolts, the traps, the parts. All sorts of shit like that. But I'm probably going to die here. to do this first go would surprise me. Because the Francozee is a pain in the arse. But I've put that down there. Whether he goes in it or not is another thing he has done. He's dead. Oh, is he? Yeah. Oh god, I got terrified then and spunked an extra harpoon bolt. But there we go. He's dead. But that's basically what you want to do there, guys. I got lucky. He could have easily charged at me. If that harpoon bolt didn't kill him outright, I probably would have died, but... That is the quickest and best way to do that. He could still kill me here on the way back.
Sebastian, I'll draw it away so you can search.
But yeah, use the shot bolt like I did. Then hit him with the explosive bolt. Do not put the explosive bolt on him. Put it next to him if you can. Sometimes he will jump to the left or right. Unfortunately, there's nothing you can do about that, because even I can't tell you guys whether he'll jump to the left or the right or forward. Fuck knows. Like I say, his AI is pretty bizarre, but I just about managed to get lucky there. I did spunk all my explosive bolts, I do believe. I might have one left, but if you want to do it quickly, that's the price you've got to pay here, basically. But yes, happy to do that on first go.
I'm sorry. It's not just about being unable to see. It's about feeling normal.
It's all
Franco
right.
Z and Ralph Z.
Let's focus on finding Kidman. Jeez, Joseph. All that for a pair of glasses.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the end of Chapter 6. A lot to take on board. And for me, I would personally say the second hardest or third hardest chapter on AKUMU. The others probably being Chapters 11 and 10. But so far during this walkthrough, I've done it all in one sitting. I'm going to have a day off now and come back to this tomorrow. Probably complete it all then. But you guys won't know that because it'll be in one playlist. 15 videos. My AKUMU Evil Within walkthrough. Enjoying this so far. The game did make me a bit salty in that chapter. The flash bolt's not working at times. A few silly deaths here and there. But I think we've only died 3 times altogether. Which I'm really happy with. Might have a new PB by the end of this in terms of amount of deaths. But obviously, like I say, I did make this walkthrough to help people who aren't as experienced with the game, to show them that AKUMU isn't that hard. You've just got to understand the game's bullshit and the mechanics and things like that. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. See you.